In this episode of I'm Surviving Man, I'm going to focus on products that are made in the USA. It's an ever-growing problem, and I've been making a conscious decision of watching the clothes I buy and the equipment I use and make sure things are made in the USA. Take this hat, the Stormy Kromer, proudly made in Michigan's Upper Peninsula. The jacket I'm wearing, Filson, authentic garment. Made in the USA, but be careful. When you look through the catalog, many of the clothes have imported under them. Usually you don't have to worry about GI issue clothing. The Gore-Tex is made by Proper or Alpha, whatever clothing you have. I got made in the USA on my jacket liner. The jacket, made in the USA, but be careful. Be careful for military style or military specs. As you can see, the field jacket, made in the Dominican Republic. I myself, I've been making a conscious decision, but I am guilty too. Take my boots. I love these boots. I just looked at them today, made in China. Instead of $120, they should be worth $5. $5 coming from China. How many countries are we enslaving the people working for pennies on the dollar in textile plants? Check your garments. See which country we are enslaving. I have to take a hike up the mountain. I got the lenses because of the snow blindness. I'm going with the ice climbers and the gaiters for the snow. Couldn't get a manufacturer on any label, so everything is suspect now. I'm going to have to go back and check to see who makes the ice climbers, gaiters, goggles. Gaiters are Cabela's, and everything at Cabela's is outsourced. I could buy the same shirt 4 years in a row, and 1 year it'll be made in Sri Lanka, Vietnam, Indonesia. So, whew. Now, I don't want to spend too much time hemming and hawing over this subject. Let's get back to big climbing with big gear. Everything, including the kitchen sink, is my motto. Let's head down the highway. I like to stop here every time. This is the hill climb. The mountain I climbed in the Catskills bragged of a 35% grade. This here is 45% grade. Climb is difficult in the snow. This is my resting point. Halfway up. You gotta watch your knees. The weight of my pack is making my feet go through the snow sometimes at unpredictable points. Successful as ever. It is a brutal climb. No doubt about it. And back to my campsite. Upon further review of some of my products, some of my gear, I found Craftsman. Can't go wrong with Craftsman. Made in the USA. I found a saw. Saw seems to be made in China, unless the saw is made in the US and the pack is made in China. But seat I bought a couple years ago, China. Happy to say the cheap Walmart propane is still made in the USA. And Coleman, I'm not too sure about Coleman. They say Wichita, Kansas on all their products, but this thing was made in China or Indonesia. The jury's still out on my stuff. Okay, my first challenge of the weekend. I seem to have left a lighter in the car. So I'm going to get this fire going with no matches. Let me demonstrate. Temperatures are in the 40s today, and there's over a foot of snow on the ground. Got some slushy conditions today. I'm going to get to work on this kindling first. I discovered some lamp oil. I'm going to try to spark up some lamp oil on a wet tissue. That would be my first attempt. I got my lamp oil.
Guess it's not flammable enough.
No luck. I'm not surviving, man.
I stand correct. I guess I'm surviving, man. Took a little bit. We're not out of the woods yet, though. Oh, yeah. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it.
All right, we got to stay on this fire. All the wood is wet, and I got to get some more dry wood. I don't have enough dry wood. Here's some wood we can use in a pinch. Looks like a downed tree. A lot of dry wood. I almost lost it. I walked away for a second just to get some wood. I dragged that tree back, and the fire went out. Put a little bit of flames on top, caught it again. This was the little baby, saved my life. Look at that, made in the USA. And I have confirmed that Coleman, the Coleman lantern, made and assembled in the USA of US and foreign components. So they still make this in the USA at least.
Everything's going. Got the fire going, cooking dinner. Having major boot problems. It was so warm out today, my feet were sweating, so my feet got wet. And I changed my socks, put lighter socks on, now my feet are cold, and I think my boots are wet, but they're Gore-Tex boots, so I don't understand how the water's getting through. I'm gonna go with my third pair of socks right now. I don't think anybody appreciates what's involved in changing socks. You gotta pull the gaiters off, pull the boots off. Surrounded by wet snow. When you got wet feet, your whole weekend becomes revolving around keeping your feet dry. Sun's going down. Temperature's dropping rapidly. It's supposed to be in the 20s tonight. I'm putting my good socks on.
I've determined that most of my gear is US made, except for select items. I'm going to do better, try to replace them with American-made items. This is something I had to show everybody. Check out my icebox. Just up here on top of the mountain, enjoying a wonderful sunset. Look at those mountains. Well, the sun sets, and the sun rises. Actually, the earth revolves around the sun. The night was very cold last night. I laid out under the stars in the snow. I gotta tackle my pile here, put it all back in my pack, and maybe eventually get the fire going. I've decided to just pack down. I'm not gonna make a fire this morning. Just gonna get out. Let me get my food out of the freezer. Frozen. My freezer door's frozen. It's not working out.
I'm preparing myself for the descend. You come back and forth to the campsite with a couple of trips and you wind up with more stuff you started with.
And I'm gonna use this as like a sled system to get down. This thing's really heavy, so I'm just gonna pull it down the ice.
I'll see you next time on I'm Surviving Man.